Hello students, I am going to start how you will be finding out perimeter and area of a rectangle and square. It's very interesting chapter. In the last video I made you understand how to go into the mind of a person who thought about all these things. So I am finding out perimeter of rectangle and square by going into the mind of that person. Perimeter is what? Sum of all the sides. The first person must have thought about this only. Sum of all the sides. This is the shape of a rectangle and this is the shape of a square. What is the definition of rectangle and square? First, I am making you understand that. Rectangle is a quadrilateral. What is quadrilateral? An area covered by four sides. If an area is covered by four sides, this is one side, second side, third side, four sides. First, second, third and fourth side. So if an area is covered by four sides, that is called quadrilateral. So this is also covered by four sides. This area is covered by four sides. This area is covered by four sides. So rectangle is a quadrilateral whose opposite sides, this side, opposite side means what? This side and this side are opposite to each other. This side and this side are opposite to each other. Opposite sides are equal and parallel. All angles are 90 degree. See, all angles are 90 degree. And diagonals bisect each other. And for a square is also a quadrilateral whose all sides are equal. Opposite sides are parallel, all angles are 90 degree and diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree. That is the definition. So through that definition, and where from they have got this definition? By looking at the figure, they have brought out this. Because all the things, first you have to think. If you will be thinking, you have to make your mind in that way only. It's not about learning. Anything is not about learning, it's about understanding. If you'll be understanding anything, you don't need to learn. You don't need to mug up anything. So you try to look at the figure and try to understand what I am trying to do. And apply your mind in that way. Perimeter, sum of all the sides. This side is opposite to this side. And this side is opposite to this side. So that means there are two types of sides. This is longer in size. So that's why I have given this name length, L. L is length. And this is shorter inside, that's why I have given this breadth. It does not mean you can't give this name as L and this name as breadth. You can give, any name you can give. But for the sake of convenience, I have given this name length and breadth. If this is length, this one will also be length. If this is breadth, this one will also be breadth. Now come to this figure. If you will be saying L, then breadth will be saying, why you have not given my name? If you will be giving breadth, then length will be saying, why you have not given my name? So for the sake of making them pacifying, what you will be doing, that you will be giving certain other name, so that both of them will be pacified. So that's why I have given S. S means side. If this is S, this is also S because all the sides are equal. This is S and this is also S. So perimeter, sum of all the sides. This is one side, L plus, sum means plus. B plus L plus B. Likewise, this is S, this is S, S and S. So how many lengths are there? 2 lengths plus 2 breadth. LL, 2L, breadth, 2 breadth. And in this case, 4S. 4S means 4 into sides. So whenever we say that 4 into sides, perimeter of a square is 4 into side, what does it mean? It is a formula, but this formula is derived from the thought of the person who first thought about it. He thought sum of all the sides. This is 2L plus 2B. So this is the formula of perimeter of rectangle. But this formula has derived from that thought only. Sum of all the sides. Now come to area. Area, I made you understand. Perimeter of shape of base into perimeter of shape of height. Now look at this carefully. When I have written this one, there are two parts in it. For area, there are two parts, this one and this one. So you come from back, base. What is base in this case? In these two figure, what is the base? Base means what? On which you are standing. On which you are standing. So this figure is standing on BC. And this figure also is standing on BC. So BC is the base. Base you have understood. Now what is the shape of base? From back you have to come. Shape of base. What is the shape of base? Base is a line segment. Base is a line segment. Now you have understood what is the shape of base. Now come to the beginning. Perimeter of shape of base. What is perimeter? Now you will not be saying the name. What you have understood, you will be saying that only. What is the perimeter of line segment? Perimeter of line segment is line segment itself. Perimeter of line segment is line segment itself. What is the name of that line segment? That is L. So in place of perimeter of shape of base, you will be writing L into height. Height. The moment this word comes into your mind, you will be standing straight. Standing straight means making 90 degree. In these two figures, where are 90 degrees made? This is the 90 degree. All the sides are equal and all the angles are 90 degree. In this case also, 90 degree. If 90 degree is made, that means height is there. If 90 degree is not there, then you have to make 90 degree. So in these two figures, 90 degree is there. So height is already there. So where is height? Height is this one. This is height. This is height. What is shape of height? Shape of height is also a line segment. Shape of height is line segment. What is perimeter of shape of height? Perimeter of line segment. Perimeter of line segment means line segment itself. What is the name of that? What is the name of height? This is the height. This is the height. The name of this height is B and the name of this height is B. Same. So I'll be writing only one B, L into B. So what is the formula of area of rectangle? L into B. Though you have found out L into B, this is the formula, but where from it has come? It has come from the mind of that person who has thought about this. The same logic applies to in square also. Perimeter of shape of base, this is shape of base. What is that shape of base? Line segment. Perimeter of line segment. Line segment itself, what is the name of that line segment? S into shape of height. Height jaise naam, then 90 degree has to be there in your mind. 90 degree you have found out. Shape of height, line segment itself. What is the perimeter of line segment? Line segment itself. What is the name of that line segment? Height. This one. This is the height and the name is S. So what you will be writing? S square. S into S is S square. You have found out the formula, but where from this formula has come? This formula has come while going into the mind of that person who has thought about this. So you have to think in that way only. You have to go into the mind. You have to apply your mind. You don't need to learn anything. You try to understand. If you'll be understanding, it will be much more easier for you. I hope you have understood how I have decoded perimeter and area of rectangle and square. Thank you, Vita.